broadcast. And this system is going to replace primary and secondary surveillance radar. This system works quite different from radar, which works by bouncing radio waves from fixed terrestrial antennas and then interpreting reflected signals. It is being used with conventional GNSS technology and related with simple broadcast communication means. Also, unlike radar, it is being used doesn't seem to degrade with range and atmospheric conditions or target altitude. And update intervals do not depend on the rotational speed of antenna and reliability of mechanical antennas. It uses ordinary GNSS receiver to derive its precise position from the GNSS constellation and then combines this information with any of aircraft's discrete such as speed, heading, altitude, or flight number. And then this information is continuously broadcast to all other ATSB-capable aircraft and ground stations or satellite communication transceiver which relays this information to air traffic control centers at real time. Next please. This is the visual presentation of the ATSB system, and it shows that all capable aircraft, stations, towers, landing vehicles simultaneously continuously broadcast the information, and it's possible to see it at special display. Next, please. ATSB consists of three main components. It's receiving subsystem, transport protocol, which consists of mode S, M, VDL4, and transmitting subsystem. This is the picture we show the ATSB tower and how it looks like. Yes, yes. There are two types of onboard installation. It may be ATSB out or ATSB in out installation. In case of ATSB out installation, the aircraft has only transmitter which simultaneously broadcasts its own aircraft information, but unfortunately cannot receive other information from other ATSB-capable aircraft or ground stations. So it is capable to see traffic information, but this aircraft is blind in this system. And in case of full suit ATSB-NOT installation, there is a transceiver which transmits our own aircraft's information and receives information from ATSB-capable aircraft, ground stations. And next slide, please. And in this case, there is a cockpit display traffic information which shows pilots the ATSB traffic situation in the representative of the moving map. And here we see how this, unfortunately, it's not a good picture, but we see our aircraft, other aircraft, maybe ground station, we see terrestrial, and all information about these aircraft and stations. And next, please. Now this is also the presentation of ATSB showing that we have the communication link between satellites, ground receivers, satellite controllers, between aircraft, and all of them are in simultaneously communication. Also, it is already currently certified that ATSB costs only 1/10 of all radars nowadays, and it helps pilots and air traffic controllers to see and to control traffic with more precision and for more power large terrestrial than it has been possible before. Next slide, please. This is also the presentation of ATSB, and also ATSB has such advantage that it may cover and provide the surveillance at the remote areas and in areas where there is no radar coverage or like above the ocean. And without radar coverage, aircraft have to fly about 80 miles apart, but under ATSB, it is possible for them to be only 5 miles apart. Next slide, please. This is a presentation of the Hudson Bay, which is situated in northern Canada, and this is the airspace demands and the amount of traffic which is demanded at this place, but there is no radar coverage at this place. Next slide, please. And by means of 5 installed ATSB ground stations, they are wind circles. It is possible now for this place to provide surveillance coverage for about 250,000 nautical square nautical miles. Next slide, please. And one of the conclusions, it's possible to say that there are such benefits of ATSB. It provides air-to-air surveillance capability. It provides surveillance at remote areas and in places where there is no radar coverage. It provides real-time traffic and information. party was far in advance. Also, it supports vertical separation and it gives the possibility to reduce the vertical separation between airports. And as it saves money on the ground and in the air. Next slide, please. And one of, as I have said at the beginning of my presentation, it is possible to use ATSB system or maybe ATSB-like system at some other at our everyday life, and it is possible to use it at the transport system. Here we also see the connection between the satellites, between ground stations, between cars, and as nowadays practically all cars have GPS. We see that it is possible to create such a system which will maintain and control our transport in our everyday life. Next slide, please. And by means of ATSB, it's possible to achieve such possibilities. To unload roads, to monitor traffic jams, problem places, small venues, and display traffic lights. Also, it's possible to broadcast continuously and it's necessary emergency information to control speed of movement,